Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you how to crochet this beautiful table runner. So for my project I'm using medium worsted yarn and the crochet hook size 4 millimeters. At the moment my project is measured about 40 inches long and 12 inches wide. This pattern is very easy if you would like to adjust the size, so we can make it even longer by adding extra loops, which I will explain during the video. And by joining 4 panels is measured about 12 inches. So again, we can add as many panels as we wish to make this project even wider. So it's completely up to you. At the end, I made a thistle for some decoration. So if you would like to know how to make it, in a comment section down below, in the video description exactly, you will find the link to another video how to make a tassel. So it's not very complicated. So basically that's it. Let's get started. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot. And at the beginning we need to work chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now into the 4th chain stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4, we are going to work treble crochet. So we still at the beginning got 3 chain stitches. Now, chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And the same as we've done before, into the 4th chain stitch we are going to work treble crochet. So 1, 2, 3 and 4 and treble crochet in our 4th chain stitch. Chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then again into the 4th chain stitch, 1, 2, 3 and 4, treble crochet. So now we are going to repeat this pattern all the time by working chain of 9 first, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then treble crochet in 4th chain stitch from our hook until we will have 22 loops like that. So in this part, when we are working treble crochet in 4th chain stitch, this we can call a loop, and so far we've done 4. Now we are going to work another 18. So again, chain of 9, treble crochet in 4th chain stitch from our hook, and again chain of 9 and another treble crochet. So we should have 22 loops for the same size as I have. If you would like to make it shorter or longer, it's completely up to you, so you need to add or make less. So I'm going to do another 18 and then I will go back to you to show you what we have to do next. Now after our last one loop, we are going to work chain of 3. So the same as we have at the beginning. At the beginning, we've just before our first loop, we've got chain 3 as well, and then chain of 4 as a chain 4 space. So chain 3 is including as our base, as exactly our center of this project. And after chain of 4 we are going directly to our first loop, and now we are going to work 4 treble crochets together. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. When we've got 5 loops, you can finish the stitch. And now chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then into the same loop, we are going to work another group of 4 treble crochets together. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we've got 5 loops, we can finish the stitch again. So in one loop we've got four treble crochets together, chain of seven, and another four, another group of four treble crochets together. Now we have to go directly to the next loop, and again we are going to start with four treble crochets together without any chain stitches. So treble crochet, but not to the end, after our last treble crochet. So we still keep the last loop on the hook. So this is the first one, second, third, and fourth. When we've got five loops on our hook, as you can see, it's not that easy, we can work through all five loops and then chain of seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Four treble crochets together in the same loop. So in each loop we are going to work exactly the same. We need to work group of four treble crochets together, then chain of seven, and another group of four treble crochets together. When we've got five loops, we can finish the stitch. And this pattern now we are going to repeat each in each loop. So I've got another 20 loop left, so I'm going to continue my pattern to the last one, and then I will go back to you to show you what we have to do next. So in each loop, four treble crochets together, chain of seven, and another four treble crochets together. Now I have my last group of four treble crochets together. Now chain of four, and then we need to work slip stitch. Let me work one more chain stitch. We need to work slip stitch at the top of our chain three space from the beginning on of our work. So chain four, then slip stitch into the first chain stitch, then another chain of four. And we are going on the opposite side, so we can actually call this round, because we are going to all the way around of the chain space from the beginning. And we need, after our chain four, we are going directly to the same loop as we've done our last group of four treble crochets together, and we have to work exactly the same. So we are going to start with four treble crochets together, then chain of seven, and another four treble crochets together. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and another four treble crochets together. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Five loops, we can finish our stitch. And then we are going to the next loop, and we have to repeat the same as we've done on our opposite side. So now we are going to continue this pattern all the way across. At the end we need to work one more chain of four, and then slip stitch in third chain stitch. So on the other side we've done chain of seven, chain three as a chain three from the beginning, then chain four as we've got here on both sides. So after the last group of four treble crochets together, we are going to work another chain of four, and then slip stitch in third chain stitch at the beginning, and then I'm going to show you how to work our next round. So basically I am at the end. I've done my last chain four stitches and slip stitch in third chain stitch here we've got beginning of our round, so slip stitch in third chain stitch. Now we need to go directly to the first chain for space, and we have to start with five single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the same we are going to make in each chain for space. So at the end and on the opposite side we've got two chain for spaces, so we have to work five single crochets in each. Then we need to go directly to the chain seven space, and we need to start with five single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then chain of three, Slip stitch at the top of our last single crochet. So at the top of our fifth single crochet. So we've got picot. And the picots we are going to use to join our parts together later on. And then another four single crochets in the same chain space. So basically we've got nine single crochets, and at the top of our fifth one we've got picot. Then one single crochet in that big loop between two groups of four treble crochets together, and we have to go to the next chain 7 space. Once again, we need to start by working 5 single crochets, 3, 4 and 5, chain of 3, slip stitch at the top of our 5th single crochet, then another 4 single crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Single crochet in next big loop between two groups, and in next chain 7 space again we are going to start with 5 single crochets, picot at the top of our 5th one, and then another 4 single crochets, so as we've done so far. So as you can see, after chain 4 space we are not working a single crochet at the top of our group, only between two. So you can quite easily see that the loops are very big, so we are working single crochets in that loops. After our last group, when we are going to work 5 single crochets in our next chain 4 space, we just go in directly from our previous chain space to the next one. So this round, in our first part, we are going to finish all the way around. So now we need to continue this pattern to the last chain 7 space. In next two chain 4 spaces we have to work 5 single crochets as well, and then we need to continue working the same on our opposite side, 5 single crochets in our last chain space. In the next parts we are going to start joining one part to another, so we are going to use the second side. So the first one we are doing exactly the same as we've done, we are making now, but we need to leave the second side, and our joining we are going to start from the first chain 7 space. I will go back to you in a minute to show you what we have to do next. So now I'm going back to show you in basically the way how we need to join our motifs together. So as you can see already, I've just joined 3 already by using each picot. So that's why I said that one side we are going to leave empty, because we are joining only the one side, and another one we can do after or before, it doesn't really matter. So after our 5 single crochets in chain 4 space, we are going directly to the first chain 7 space, and we need to start working with our pattern. So 5 single crochets, then chain 1, and instead of second chain stitch we are going to the first picot of our previous part, and we have to join. So we need to insert crochet hook into the picot, grab the yarn and work slip stitch, then one more chain 1, so this is our third chain stitch of a picot, and then slip stitch in our fifth single crochet. So now to our chain, the same chain space, we have to work another 4 single crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4. That's, so the same as we've done before. And then we have to work 1 single crochet in space between two groups. Then we are going to the next chain 7 space, and we have to work another 5 single crochets, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then again chain 1, instead of chain of 2 we are going to work slip stitch in next picot, chain 1, then slip stitch in chain 5 space. Now another 4 single crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4. then single crochet between our two groups, and we are going to the next chain 7 space. So basically we need to repeat this pattern to the end of this row. So I just started by working single crochets in our first chain 4 space. So we need to finish in our last. But also, maybe I forgot to tell you, I'm going to add extra decoration, tassels at the end, so you probably saw it already at the beginning of the video. So if we are working with first group of 5 single crochets, we can work single crochet directly into the third chain stitch of our, we can call it double crochet, work picot at the top of this single crochet, and then we can work another 5 single crochets. So it's gonna be much easier to join our tassel at the end to the picot than between 2 single crochets. But this part is completely up to you. So now that's it for today. If you like this type of project, just let me in the comment section down below this video, and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.